In an era where our planet faces unprecedented environmental challenges, gaining a deep understanding of ecosystem is not just a scientific endeavor, but a moral and practical imperative. Welcome to ASH Little Topper. In this video, we will begin by traveling into the concepts of ecosystem and how they operate as an interconnected system. If ecology has to be studied in detail, the basic unit starts from the ecosystem. Gain a deep understanding of the fascinating world of ecosystems as we take you on this enlightening journey. So let's have some discussion on what is ecosystem, components of ecosystem, types of ecosystem, and functions of ecosystem. What is ecosystem? An ecosystem is a structural and functional unit of biosphere. It is made up of living and non-living beings and their physical environment. The interaction and interrelationship between the living community, which is plants, animals, and organisms, in relation to each other, and the non-living community, which is soil, air, and water, is referred to us as an ecosystem. Components of ecosystem. Components of ecosystem is basically divided into biotic and abiotic components. Biotic components of an ecosystem are the living things that have a direct or indirect influence on other organisms in an environment. It includes plants, animals, and microorganisms and their waste materials. In abiotic components of an ecosystem includes all chemical and physical elements which are non-living components. It can vary from region to region, from one ecosystem to another, and consist of climate or factors of climate such as temperature, light, humidity, precipitation, gases, wind, water, soil, salinity, minerals, and habitat. Ecosystem is basically divided into biotic and abiotic components. Biotic components are further divided into producer, consumer, and decomposer. Consumer is further subdivided into primary consumer, secondary consumer, and tertiary consumer. Whereas primary consumer is called as herbivores, secondary consumer is called primary carnivores, and tertiary consumer is called as secondary carnivores. Producers of biotic component in an ecosystem. Producers are plants that can synthesize their own food and energy requirements through photosynthesis in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. All other living organisms rely on plants for their energy as well as food in the form of oxygen. Producers can be further divided into two categories, phototrophs and chemotrophs. Phototrophs are organisms that use the sun's energy to convert carbon dioxide into carbohydrates. Chemotrophs get their energy mostly from carbon dioxide and other inorganic compounds which they get through a process known as chemosynthesis. Consumers of a biotic component in an ecosystem. Consumers are the organisms that eat the food that producers have prepared. Consumers are in three stages, which are primary consumer, secondary consumer, and tertiary consumer. Primary consumers are known as herbivores. They are directly dependent on plants. They are part of food chain's second trophic level, example, cows, goats, and deer. Secondary consumers are known as carnivores. They eat primary consumers and are found at the third trophic level of the food chain. Example, foxes, dogs, and cats. Tertiary consumers can be carnivores or omnivores, organisms that depend on secondary consumers for food. Example, wolf eats fox. Decomposer of an biotic component in an ecosystem. Decomposers are known as saprophytes, fungi and bacteria that decompose organic matter. They eat dead plants and animals and use a variety of chemical reactions to convert them to nitrogen and carbon dioxide. Saprophytes are an important part of the ecosystem because they recycle nutrients that can then be utilized by producers who are planted to generate their own energy. Types of ecosystem. Ecosystem is basically divided into aquatic ecosystem and terrestrial ecosystem. So marine ecosystem and freshwater ecosystem comes under aquatic ecosystem, whereas the terrestrial ecosystem consists of forest ecosystem, desert ecosystem, grassland ecosystem, and mountain ecosystem. Let's start with the giant aquatic ecosystem. Aquatic ecosystems are ecosystems present inside water bodies. The aquatic ecosystem consists mainly of animals and organisms that stay in the water bodies, such as lakes, oceans, and seas. The best example is fish and amphibians. Organisms survive using the oxygen dissolved in water. This ecosystem is much larger than the terrestrial ecosystem as it acquires a greater part of the earth. Aquatic ecosystem is further divided into marine ecosystem and freshwater ecosystem. Marine ecosystem has a unique flora and fauna and supports a vast kingdom of species. Biggest of all ecosystems and contains salt marshes, intertidal zones, lagoons, mangroves, coral reef, and the seafloor. Coral reef provides food and shelter to the highest number of marine inhabitants in the world. Freshwater ecosystem is an aquatic ecosystem that includes lakes, ponds, rivers, streams, and wetlands. They have no salt content in contrast with the marine ecosystem, and it is further divided into lentic, lotic, and wetlands. Lentic, or the water bodies that are moving slowly or still in the same place, comes under lentic, which is ponds, lakes, and pools. Lotic, or the water bodies that are moving at a fast pace, fall under a lotic, which is streams and rivers. Wetlands are environmental characterized by soils saturated with water for a long time, fall under wetlands. Terrestrial ecosystem. Terrestrial ecosystems are those ecosystems that exist on land. Terrestrial ecosystems are distinguished from aquatic ecosystems by the lower availability of water. These are categorized by greater temperature fluctuation on seasonal basis. Availability of light is greater in terrestrial ecosystems than in aquatic ecosystem because the atmosphere is more transparent on land than in water. So terrestrial ecosystem has forest ecosystem, desert ecosystem, mountain ecosystem, and grassland ecosystem. Forest ecosystems are densely packed environment of various flora and fauna. It has the highest number of organisms living in forest ecosystem. It is important to conserve their ecosystem as many rare species of the earth are found here, which is tiger, lion, and elephant. Desert ecosystem receives rainfall of less than 25 cm, indicating extreme climate. There are organisms that have resistance towards high temperature and plants that require very little water to survive, having modified their leaves and stem to conserve water, which are camels, cacti, and rattlesnakes. Mountain ecosystems are regions of high altitude above sea level with scattered vegetation. It also has an extreme climate, and animals of these regions have developed thick fur on the skin to survive the cold climate. Grassland ecosystem mainly includes shrubs, herbs, and few trees which are not as dense as the forest. These basically include grazing animals, insectivores, herbivores. The temperature are not too extreme in these ecosystems. The last is functions of ecosystem. It helps to regulate all basic ecological process, manages life system, and ensures sustainability. It participates in maintaining an equilibrium structural process between different trophic levels of ecosystem components. It is responsible for cycling minerals through the biosphere. It maintains and regulates nutrition cycle between abiotic and biotic ecosystem components. Along with abiotic components, the ecosystem participates in the synthesis of organic components, primarily responsible for transferring energy. However, the story of ecosystems is not one-sided. We will also confront the challenges that they face in the wake of habitat destruction, pollution, climate change, and human activities. Thank you for joining us on this journey to explore ecosystems. Remember to appreciate and protect our ecosystem as they are the key to a healthier and more sustainable future. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more informative videos like this one.